You know what it takes, and you're ready today.
Yeah, first go, mate.
You got the measure of your man, and you know that you can go all the way. Give it to him. Yeah, give him a taste.
Let's go.
Let's go. All right. No my hook and my welcome back to another episode of the Kiwi NRL podcast tonight. Oh, that's what I was doing. Hey, remember?
I know. I was waiting to see if you'd remember, but hi, I'm your host, Lenny.
Tonight, I'm your host, Lenny, and beside me, my Lucy Lefty, left-hand man, Jason Witherley. How are you, sir?
I'm good. I'm great. Good weekend. Bit of a wet weekend, but a good weekend.
It's moist.
It was moist. I got out and played golf, though.
Did you?
Yeah, went out to Tito with Danny P.
Danny P, eh?
It was a goodie. But muddy, I slipped over.
Who won?
For those who play golf, we play Stableford. And I won by one or two, I think.
Oh, hey, like that, Danny P.
Yeah, he was not happy.
Get that up, yeah, bro.
And then I smoked him at pool.
Oh, jeez, what's doing?
I know. Couldn't lose.
I thought he was a bit alpha, but obviously not. Obviously not. Now I've lost track.
How completely. Was your weekend?
Oh, my weekend? It was great. What did I do?
Don't know. I see the
can't remember. Watch the Warriors.
Tooth Fairy visited yours last night.
Yeah, the young fella lost his first baby tooth.
Yeah.
It was very wiggly, but that came out, and then he got a five buckaroo.
Did that come out naturally, or did you have to?
Nah, he let that as natural. It was so wiggly.
Those ones.
I was like, just let me pull it out, bro. But he wouldn't let me. But, yeah, anyway, so we had a tooth come out. What else did I do on the weekend? Yeah, not much.
Not much?
Can't really remember. That's shocking, isn't it?
Also, before we go on, shout out to Hums and Gabby for scaring poor Billy.
Scaring their baby. Yeah, I don't know if they get a shout out for that.
That was great.
Sweet. All right. Give a shout out to the sponsors. Haven't done the board again.
Fit Zone. What have we got going on?
Well, mate, we just kicked off, all right? The My Zone challenge between Fit Zone, all four Fit Zone clubs, and the two bout fitness clubs over at Papa Mora and the Mount. So it's a MEP challenge. You've got the My Zone bout. You know, it measures your effort, your heart rate, and from that it gives you some MEP points. So we're doing us versus them, a little friendly battle. Then it kicked off and we're in front just. But yeah, it's going great. But if you are in the market for a My Zone bout, we sell those online from the website.
Oh, how good.
FitZoneNZ.com. You can get one of those and be part of the team if you were that way inclined. You can even lay by it if you want to.
Lay by her.
Get how good. All right. That would lead us into another one. Another plug.
A plug.
Hey. Hey, blow up.
What? All right, it's back. The second week of our new segment, really.
Yes.
The plug they asked for, Jason. What?
They're gonna get it this time.
Turns out they're gonna get it because they gave us free stuff. But not only that, it's a great drop.
It is the virtual reality. It's good.
Non-alcoholic hazy IPA. We're still smashing them back.
I actually enjoy having these in the. On a Monday.
Yeah, it's just during the week. They're quite handy to have around. So if you're feeling it like you're needing a beer and you're trying to watch how much your alcohol consumption.
Yes.
These are perfect.
Low in calories, I hear, as well.
Very low in calories. 26 calories a can.
Whoo! How good.
So for one normal beer, you can have probably three of these and still be less than that.
Yes.
Well, if you're thinking that's a low-carb one.
Yeah.
If you're thinking of a doozy hazy, like a proper one.
You have a box of these.
You could have, that's 180 cals, so you'd probably have a box and still not have the same as one beer.
Shit, man.
So, you know, it does wonders for the rig. Does wonders for the liver. So, yeah, and also, good George, don't forget, they got the VR challenge for Dry July. You can still get amongst it. Basically, they're giving away a crack of couple of fridges, a gangster as, like, I want one. Buy one of these bad boys, you're in the draw. And if you go online and get the VR challenge pack, which has 30 of these in it.
Plus
six deck chair, hazy yes. Pale ales. You get 10 entries into that draw to get that fridge, and that you get it's a lot cheaper than buying, you know, a pack a week or whatever.
So get amongst it.
Get amongst it. Shout out to the good folks over at.
Is there still 10% promotion running?
Oh, there's still 10% off the best. So go to their website, www.goodgeorge.kiwi.nz.
Yes. Yes. And if you put in a Kiwi...
Yes, the code, yeah, that's probably a good idea to say that. Kiwi NRL 10. So Kiwi NRL 10 gives you 10% off site-wide when you're doing online orders for your bevvies.
I'm definitely going to be doing that. I'm going to get a gin, actually.
Did you see the latest one?
The nectarine one?
They got the alcohol-free one. Pink gin.
Oh, man, I'm going to have to get that.
See? They're just looking out for people, you know? So good on you, Good George. Thanks again, you know. So if you support the potty, get along, buy some beers off Good George from their website, Kiwi NRL 10. We got our discount code.
Also.
Discount code. Yeah.
If you are at a Good George.
Yes.
I highly recommend their ginger beers. The non-alcoholic one, good. And alcoholic one is good.
And I think, well, in Matamata they have at the merchant, they have this on tap.
Yeah, they do. I was talking to young Simon.
Which is great. So, anyway, get amongst it. Good George, dry July. Does wonders for the liver. Wonders for the rig. Why not? Why wouldn't you? All right. Next segment.
Questions. Oh, I need to get that ready. Do we put questions up?
I did. Don't know how many we got in, but... Thanks a lot. Oh, we just won't say that. All right.
Okay. Questions.
Questions. Can they get an answer? We sure hope so.
First question. With the talk about JMK possibly out for the season.
Yes.
What does this do for the Kiwis?
What does it do? Well, it makes Brandon pretty much a shoo-in once fit.
Yeah. Or depending how he's going, would you slip Nicarima in there?
Oh, yeah. Slip the old knickers in there.
He'd go a good try in the weekend.
Slip old knickers in there. No, he's sneaky. He got a sneaky try. Yeah, possibly. But I think if Brandon's fit, he's...
Yeah. In there.
He's in there. Yeah, that's pretty gutting. Finding some of his best form. And the Dolphins, we'll get into it later, but the Dolphins are a different team when he's on the park. That's for sure. That is for sure. It's a shame for the Dolphins, too. They kind of need him.
Yeah. He's a big part of their attack.
But messaged him yesterday, and he's getting his scans done this afternoon on it, so...
Nice.
We might have already got them done. So all the best of luck, mate. Hopefully it's not too bad. If you're
listening, let us know how that goes, because I'm a big fan.
Big fan, yep, you are. You're a big fanny.
have you got any questions?
Yes, another question. There's a few hidings in the weekend.
Yes.
A few hidings. So obviously with the competition being so close... Like, is this a question or a statement? I'm not sure. Competition being so close, can you pretty much just put a line through those three teams that got humped in the weekend? They're done, right?
Oh, yeah.
Because there's a gap between, like, from 1 to, I don't know, 15 or whatever. How many teams are there? 17.
17. I think the bottom three are just out of it.
There's, like, a massive gap between the bottom three and the rest, but yeah. The rest are real close.
Yeah.
So it's this random thing where it's, like, most of the comp is real close. Except for the three bottom clubs, they just...
Yeah. And it's weird because Bulldogs had more signings than us, or better signings than us, you would think.
Yep.
But they just haven't capitalised. They had injuries, I'll give them that. But
so did we.
So did we.
Yeah, but with all the superstars they signed, and they got the best coach, apparently. Yeah. Not looking too good.
And they got Critter, is it? Critter going there next year?
Going next year, you won't be looking like in the look of that.
Yeah. Feel sorry for... The likes of Papalihi from a great club.
Yeah.
But I see there's talks about Benji Marshall taking over the reins sooner.
Why not?
Hey, what do you got to lose?
The Tim Sheen thing ain't working.
Well, yeah, exactly.
Also, another question got sent in from the Warrior Holic. He asked, who is going to pair Sean Johnson?
Yeah. Oh, and for the Kiwis or for the...
I'll actually bring it up. It's just it's not in the questions. It's actually in the message. There, yeah. Without SJ. Yeah. Oh, so without I'm assuming SJ. This weekend.
So SJ is supposed to be missing this week for the birth of his second child, which is fair enough. Like, hey man, I'm not angry.
Lukey Met and Timati, if he's fit.
Yeah.
Who? I think it's fit. He was close to coming back the other week, wasn't he?
I assumed he was, and there was talks.
If it's not him, it'll be Ronnie, I'd say.
Ronnie, and then who would you run at seven?
If I had Lukey Met and Ronnie, Ronnie would be seven.
Yeah, that's what I've...
But even if Tamati came back, Tamati would have to be the seven out of those two because you probably want the more senior playmaker.
Yeah.
But I'd say Tamati, Martin, and...
I wonder if they can do...
Oh, D-Walks could probably slot in if Tamati's not fit.
I was wondering if they're going to do a D-Walks because he slides in there quite well.
Oh, he slides in there real nice.
Yeah, he slides in there. He's quite good, old Dylan Walks. Like,
quite good. He is middle, man.
But
he's
like,
good.
He just like can play anywhere.
He's got great legs.
How good is it having a middle that can just put a young grubber through?
He can literally play anywhere, the lad.
Mm.
Sweet. So that's all the questions.
Yes.
That's all the questions. All right. That was a shorter segment than usual. So don't forget, people, send in your questions. The good, the bad, the ugly. Nothing offensive, though.
Yeah. We don't want that.
All right, review of the previous round. First game of last round, Jase, what is it, man?
Well, the Sharkies taking on the Dragons.
Wow.
52-16. I think we all seen it was going to go this way.
Yes.
Sharkies started off slow, though.
Yeah. I mean, we were behind it at one point, weren't we, last week too?
Yeah.
So they kind of, but they just know they're not going to hang. They're not going to hang.
Yeah. But you can see, like, oh, what's his name? Ben Hunt. He just doesn't want to be there.
Hates the club.
Lomax has been said he can look elsewhere.
I reckon he hates the club too. Yeah, it's just a stink-ass place to be if you're a Dragons fan.
Yeah.
Or a Dragons player.
Good game for Sharks though. Nikura.
Great game for the Sharkies. A couple of Kiwi boys in there played a good game. Yeah, Nikura, what do you got for us?
Hold up. I was on the thing. Nikura. He got two tries. A couple of line breaks.
Two tries.
A try assist.
Try assist?
Oh, a tackle break, actually.
Ah, tackle break.
And 32 tackles for 73 metres. He was good.
Had a great
running,
game.
Running that great line again.
He just
off Hines.
He just knows. That's all he knows. Run that line hard, bruh.
Old. Who's their coach, Fitzy? Must be stoked that he's not losing Hines or anything for Origin.
Yeah. I mean, you're happy for the players when they get caught up, but you're kind of stoked if they don't get them, if you get to keep them back at your club. Other Kiwi, Molly Talo, had a solid airs game, good, great game. Two tries, two line breaks, and he's hissing.
He's hissing.
He's a hisser. Old Ronald. Ronaldo.
And breaking news, I actually got a multi off this game.
Yes, thank goodness. It's like hearing you saying you nearly got one.
I know. Molitalo, two or more tries. Onto Will Kennedy. Onto Nikota.
Will Kennedy get a try? Should be paying like 90 cents.
And he's so good.
He's the man. He's so good, Will Kennedy.
Like, he's always been like good, but this year, he's just like everywhere in their attack.
He just sniffs it out like like a bloodhound.
Exactly. What about Harmanuelli?
Yes, I always kind of forget that he's a,
he's had a Kiwi lad. Good game. I don't actually got any stats on him, but he did an all right game, I'm pretty sure.
Solid game. The game was set up front.
Yeah.
To allow the backs to do their thing. So
do their thing.
Yeah, all right.
Skip that game.
So Dragons are cucker. Yeah, there's another game out on the...
on the first game on the Friday. That was all right, I guess. Yeah. No, actually, what I did like about that... Sorry, the game is Warriors went down 6-28
to the Rabbitohs.
When the boys ran out, that shit gave me goosebumps.
That was mean.
Johnson was loving it.
We didn't win, but the lights were out.
We didn't do ourselves any favours, but holy fuck, that was some bad weather. And shout out to the fans that got out there.
So the fans actually went. That is crazy, man. That looked hectic.
Like the puddles on the pitch, holy hecker.
Shout out to Matua Mark on the mic.
Yeah.
At the ground getting bloody, absolutely saturated.
Blasted on by old Mother Nature.
In the puddles.
Yeah.
They were puddling up.
Rabbitohs really just put on a clinic. Did they end up making more than one error, or was it just the one error?
I don't know, but in the second half, I don't think they made one.
Yeah, insane.
That's crazy. We made some. Yeah. I think that was a difference in the end.
They deserve the win. Our boys tried hard. Tohu was amazing still.
Out the gate. There's just key moments, like that forward pass from Barnett when we had them under the pump.
Yeah.
That was a really nice line. If that was a good pass, it probably would.
Actually, the fuck refs.
What they do? Oh, yeah. What, for sending the bro off?
Yeah. When, like, I see the difference, but, like, they did four. Surely after the fourth one, you sent the you one sent of them off.
After three, the fourth one should have went.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I get you. Yep. I think Adams was a send-off, but I know what you're saying.
Adams was a send-off because he had more force in it. But they did three.
But how many
and then got their fourth one.
Before you send someone off? How many head highs are you allowed to do before you just...
Well...
Sounds like five.
Apparently. Because they were in that quick succession. Yeah, quick succession.
Yeah, they were. Bang, bang.
Like, should have sent someone off. That's, like... I accepted Adam going off. I was just more angry that they didn't get someone sent off because
earlier, yeah,
they did so many in a row. Even though I knew Adams was work, that was an annoying thing.
Yeah, well, I think we were going rumbling along really nicely in the first 20 to 30 minutes, but like you said, the Rabbitohs turned the screws. I think a lot of our play was kind of go a bit sideways.
Yeah,
too much, and in the wet weather against the Rabbitohs, their defensive slide over, and then you're too close to the side. If you're 10 meters from the sideline, you're going out.
Yeah.
So they played that well. I think they just kicked a lot better than us.
Yeah, the young debut was he debuting?
The young fella, yeah.
He played good.
It was mean, yeah.
Didn't really. Yeah, didn't really get to see his speed, which I was kind of wanting to see how quick he was, because apparently he's super quick.
But to make no errors on a night like that, did he make one? I don't know. He was copping a lot of the ball, so shout out to the young fella. I think our Warriors boys tried hard, but I think our game plan was just either... incorrect or not.
And I think
the one we were supposed to do didn't happen.
Yeah, I think the boys are coming out firing. Like, we will have them firing this weekend.
Looked a bit tired too in the last 20, I'd say.
Yeah.
Compared to other games. So maybe
it'll been a hard game. Like,
maybe the schedule as well. Catching up on them a little bit.
Yeah. We got this game. I think we've got three more games and then they got a bye.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Then we finish out the season on the last six games or something.
Six wins straight.
And then finals footy.
Straight into finals. Shit, it's not a gimme, is it? Because now they're what? Seventh again? Eighth.
Eighth. But third and eighth are all in the same points.
That is effed. That is actual crazy. That is mad.
And on that, there was a Warriors' biggest defeat of the year, and it was 22 points. Like, when was the last time our biggest defeat of the year in this far into the season was 22 points?
It was a good stat, man, I'll tell you. But I'm not sure. It would have been fucking ages ago.
Probably 2002 or something.
Maybe. Maybe our last finals.
Yeah. Kiwis and Rabbitohs.
No. All right.
But yeah, shout out to who you were great.
Tohu was done the mahi, man.
Yeah.
Done the bloody mahi.
And next game, the Chokers versus the Panthers. I mean, Storm versus the Panthers. they gave a 14-0 lead.
How'd they lose?
That's not Storm-like.
No, that was a little bit of a collapse, wasn't it?
Because I only watched the start of this game. Penrith looked... shaky at the start.
Mm, yeah.
Making so many errors and then...
Made quite a few errors, that's right.
Dumb penalties given away. But just Penrith stuff.
They just know how to win. Nas, pretty good game. They moved him to the edge, obviously.
Yeah. And people were complaining about that try of his. That's not on him. That's on the bunker stuffing that up.
Yeah, if that... Yeah. It looked like maybe it wasn't one, but hey. It goes down on the fact sheet. It goes down on NRL.com.
If it wasn't He clearly dropped it by the looks, but the bunker got it wrong. So, hey, good try, anyway, mate.
So, he's got a try. It's on the stat sheet. He's done 73 metres.
Him on the edge is so dangerous.
Oh, yeah, it's crazy. I still prefer him in the middle.
I know, honest.
But, yeah, it's scary. It's
just
a scary
with all the injuries I've had, like with Katoa out. I love seeing him on the edge.
73 metres, 31 post-contact, 6 tackle breaks, a play the ball speed of 26 seconds. 26.9, so 27. No.
2.69.
That's 2.7 seconds, fucking fast.
How is the bro not penalised?
Yeah, that's fucking slow play the ball. 2.69 seconds, all right? Play the ball speed, which is the fastest I could find of the weekend. 2 offloads, 1 try-ish from the big man. Will Warbrick obviously didn't play the whole game. Stats reflected that.
Yeah, big HIA for the poor guy.
Yeah, so...
Husey, how did he go?
I think he's played pretty well. I don't think he played
badly. I think when Munster's back, Munster kind of takes more of the attack.
Yeah, but I think, Husey's definitely come into better form.
Yeah.
I think there's a lot of things going against the Storm near the end there that didn't really help them. But on the Penrith side, the Fish, the Big Fish, another solid game for the Fish.
He did.
112 metres, 21 post contact, 2 tackle breaks, a playable speed of 2.97 seconds, which is great. Anything under 3 seconds is fast.
Especially with the big boys.
Yeah, 1 off load, 27 tackles. So, and another guy who was good, another Kiwi, Sorensen.
Yeah, he went off injured as well.
Yeah, which is a bugger.
But I think it's not that bad. Like, he's got his bye this week and he should be back.
Yeah. 115 run metres, 42 post contact, 1 off load, 27 tackles as well. And then obviously up the front, we've got big Moses Leota with 26 tackles. A play the ball speed of 2.96. So that's the same. Oh, no, just a bit faster than the Fish. 1 tackle break, 32 post contact meters. And I mean, the play the ball speed these two are generating.
Mm.
I don't think you find another prop pairing in the game if you go through the stats that play the ball speed is that fast, which is a big part of what they how they do what they do.
Would the Warriors would be this year would be pretty quick.
Yeah, no, you get some pretty quick ones, but I think consistently the Fish and the Leota.
And that's are up why there. They're on the top, Penrith. It's the forwards that are just setting the like groundwork and then
Hard. They're, you know, hitting their front, getting up, playing the ball quickly, and that's what you want from your big fellas. All right.
Nick game. Raiders beat the Titans 26-22. It was a good game. Raiders, they're looking good this year.
Yeah, I mean, they have their moments, but yeah, they have probably, have, especially lately, they've had more good moments than bad ones.
Because I like when the Raiders go good, because they have a lot of, like, their fans are, like, real spirited, yeah, like, they're real
in fan base, yeah.
But
all their fans have got the clap as well.
That's what I hear.
They've all got the clap.
So let's maybe stay clear a little bit.
Kiwi lads in that team, there are a few.
Half the teams in the Raiders is Kiwi.
Yeah, so, but obviously there's one that stood out for me. Well, there's a few, but Team Walker was outstanding.
Yep.
Run meters, 212. One sick try. 49 post-contact meters. 1 line break. 3 tackle breaks. How good.
And his try was great. And nothing on his try, but that was just laziness from the Titans. They were waiting for the whistle.
Yep.
And you learn from young age, play to the whistle.
Play to the whistle, and Raps set that up.
Yeah, Raps, man.
He's an effort player. He had a great game as well. He had 111 run metres, 43 post-contact metres, 1 line break, 1 try assist, obviously it's that try, and 3 tackle breaks. The old boy still, the thing that you know about Raps, or Jordan Rapana, he's always going to have a crack. He's always going to give it his best. And he's just a competitor, eh?
And then whenever the camera goes on him, he always looks gutted. I don't know why.
Yeah, why does he do that? I don't know. Also,
Tarpini.
Big taps.
The bro had a great game.
Speak to me.
He had the 1 line break, 6 tackle breaks, 72 post contact. Even chucked an offload in there for 43 tackles and 0 missed.
Wow.
And 181 metres. The bro was a machine.
Hello.
Yeah.
What a weapon, eh? What an absolute weapon.
And that's why he's one of the best props in the game.
Yep, and he's just warming into his mahi again. I feel like he's been pretty solid all year. But
yeah, really be warming up perfectly for the Kiwis.
Really starting to find his groove.
Yes.
All right, anyone else in there? I guess Seb Chris got a young meaty.
Did he?
Sebastian Chris, yep.
Yeah, that's right.
Off that kick. And I think Foz had a pretty solid game.
Yeah.
Aaron Clark played for a bit. They were solid as well. Yep, he's ticking along.
Just doing Aaron Clark things at the moment.
Yeah, I just think maybe
he needs to be shifted.
Maybe if he played somewhere else.
Yeah.
Get some more game time. What, you have any other notes on that game, mate?
Not notes, just suggestions to NRL.com.
Yes.
Why is Team Walker not on the site?
He's not on the site, so you have to go to the game to see all the stats. But he doesn't have a profile, a player profile, eh?
Yeah.
What's he doing?
Highly frustrating.
Highly frustrating when you want to look at this outstanding human every week.
Yes.
And you can't see him on your website.
I think actually Foz had a real good like try save in that game, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, it's standard.
He got back and like he was the only one back there, saved a try, I'm pretty sure, and then the rest of the team got back. So on your Foz.
All right, next game. Cowboys absolutely dicked the Tigers.
Fuck this. Did you watch this game?
Most of it, yep.
Did you watch the start? And fuck, it was a good... probably shouldn't be here, but it was a good contest. I was like, man, this is going to be a good game.
And then it just wasn't. Oh, it was great for the Cowboys.
Junior Tupou?
Yeah.
He made one mistake, and then it almost has changed the whole game. Cowboys got on the front foot.
I mean, that's scary, eh, when they get going, the Cowboys, shit.
Yeah. Glad we've versed them already. Shit.
Do you know who was good? Who was solid? And made a bit of a return to form? Peter Hiku.
Old Kuru.
Kuru. Peter Hiku.
He was good.
106 run meters, 42 post contact, 3 tackle breaks, 1 offload. Back to his best. Good to see that happening for Pet. And the West Coast Polar Bear had a stonker. Had an absolute great game. I think he ran over 208 run meters, 80 post contact meters, 2 tackle breaks.
He got so close to scoring a try too.
So close. That would have been my Kiwi moment, bro.
Yeah.
If you would have got that little try, love me a bit of bloody West Coast Polar Bear action. Did you have any other notes from that? Any from any other Kiwi boys in there? There weren't that many in the Tigers. I mean, you can't really. Shout out any of the Tigers boys, unfortunately.
Yeah. You can't really. Yeah.
Not a Kiwi, but Drinkwater is outstanding, eh?
Drinkwater, man. He's been pulled into number 19 for New South Wales, I think. Bro should be in there. He was insane.
Yeah, he's great. Val is also great.
He's a big part of their attack.
Massive. He's just... This year is like, whoa, shit. Because he's always been real good.
Wait, who are we talking about?
Val.
Oh, Val.
Yeah. Yep. But this year has just gone to another level. Also, after Origin.
Yeah, he got the most points for Cowboys history in a single game.
How much?
30.
Holy shit. That's a lot of points.
There was a mad... Someone put up mad stat. He spent 12 minutes kicking or something.
Oh my goodness. That is embarrassing. Tigers fans. Oh.
I'm pretty sure it was 12 minutes. I was like, that's a lot of time.
Tigers fans will be feeling it right now. That would be a rough weekend. So,
yeah.
Unlucky uses.
I think, yeah. You can't really go in. Like, I think Papali did the best he could.
It's one of those things. I can't really give him a shout.
Because, like, there would have been that many missed tackles in that team.
Plus, you just can't... 74-0, you can't... I'm sorry, you can't shout anyone out.
Yeah. Next game, I didn't actually watch this game, but...
I watched most of it. It's a good
meet Broncos
game.
Versus Dolphins.
Broncos-Dolphins. A lot of people thought the Dolphins would just get pumped, but I was...
They just did Dolphin stuff.
They did. They kept themselves in the game. I think Jeremy Marshall King was massive, so when he went off injured, that's not great. And he's like... Man, they're a different team when he's playing. Bromwich boys. I think Jess had one of his better games, actually. Providing a solid platform. The odd note, actually. I had a couple of notes. Valence Tefari was a handful. Rugby league handful, isn't he?
He looks funny to tackle. Like, he doesn't, when he got his try, he wasn't moving, real fast.
No.
He's just this, nugget that just pushes back.
He got 2 line breaks, 161 run metres, 1 try, and 60 post-contact metres.
Mad.
Brilliant innings. Who else in the Kiwis? You got Cody Nikorima, like we said earlier, got a sneaky try. He's going well there at the Dolphins. It's good to see him playing some good footy.
Yeah, and getting more game time.
Amen. No try for Isako.
No.
This week.
So, I think... what's his name? We're just talking about him. Holmes is almost caught.
Him now.
Well, he got 30 points in the weekend.
30
so.
Points. Jesus, come on, Tigers. what do you do at training that week after getting pumped like that?
What do you reckon?
It's like one of those things, do you go harder on the boys or is it like, they need a button off?
Yeah. Even in the sheds afterwards, it's one of the things you don't want to be in the sheds and that one guy that makes a joke about, doesn't about the game, but just about anything because you might get hated on. It'd be a weird feeling.
Did you even talk
sheds.
About it that night? You just want to erase that and start again.
Yeah. Have some virtual reality beers.
Broncos, Dolphins, though. I think also who else are in the Broncos? What's his name? Brendan Piakura. He had a pretty good game.
Yeah.
He's coming into his own. 4 tackle breaks, 45 post contact meters, 75 run meters, and 26 tackles. So.
And he's going to be in the team for the next few weeks or a couple of months probably because Jordan Ricky's out.
Yes, yep.
Unlucky, because Ricky was he was playing some great footy.
He's playing great footy. Yep. Okay.
To the next game.
Another humping.
Yeah.
66-0 to the
Knights
versus the Bulldogs. Like, I didn't see that happening. I didn't think the Bulldogs would win, but...
Where was I? Because I didn't watch this game.
I just didn't think they'd get pumped like that.
I was in Tauranga. I was like, I just went to check my fantasy. I was like, I got Ponga on my team. I was like, 59 points. Man, I don't think the game's even gone that long.
Yeah, shit. What happened there? Doggy shit. But we said earlier, they had the signings, had the coach. They did have a few injuries, but, you know, you want to be made out of better stuff than that. And that was not, that's not up to task at all.
Yeah.
Speaking about Kiwis in there. Greg Marju, 214 run metres, 26 post contact metres, one try, one line break, 15 tackle breaks. The man is a weapon, absolute weapon. Leo Thompson had a pretty solid game too, probably wasn't the best game ever he played from memory. But he's still doing solid mahi, so it's good to see him still getting solid minutes. But yeah, it's Bulldogs. Back to the drawing board for them too. I don't think Hayes had his best game ever, but it's hard when you're... Your team's not firing like that.
Yeah. It's a weird one.
Yeah. But we can leave... Yeah.
We can leave that to the coaches to sort that one.
Yeah, they can sort that shit out. I've got no idea.
Last game. Last game of the round. It was a good game, actually.
Yeah, close one.
Seagulls, get it done over the Roosters. Roosters, man.
Just can't find a win.
Can't find a win. Seagulls beat the Cox. 18-16.
Yeah, well... Daly Terry Evans, eh?
Fuck, he was good.
The man is playing great footies too. How old is he, like 33 or something?
Though, that try he got for the intercept, copied that off SJ.
That's the SJ, yeah, it had SJ written all over it. Joey Munnu was massive though.
Yep.
For the Cox.
He was good. You got it or I got it?
We got it? If you got it, you got it, man.
Yeah. He got a try assist, which was a great try assist flick pass. One line break, 13 tackle breaks.
13.
The bro was mad. Wow. One offload, 14 tackles, and 129 metres.
129 metres?
He was probably the best player on the team, probably.
Sorry, man, my watch is just doing all sorts of shit.
What's up with your heart?
I'm just turning my watch off.
Man, it just keeps showing me, like...
I was trying to... Okay, it's calmed down. It's calmed down. All right, yeah, sorry. He had a massive game.
Yes, he's probably the best player, really.
He was the best player. And that was from centre, too. All that stuff you read out.
Yeah.
From centre. Like, it's not always easy to get your metres in that in centre, but, I mean, he's the best player, obviously.
Side note, not Kiwi, but looked like Tedesco wasn't trying to do as much, and he looked better.
Yeah, well, people have been saying that for the last 4 or 5 weeks.
Yeah.
Just needs to, like, it's hard for him because he always wants to try his best to, like, try and win it for the boys, but I think Tedesco just needed to relax a little bit, and I think letting Joey getting some of that good ball, obviously, almost paid a dividend.
I think they kept to their sides almost.
Yeah, yeah. That's good, I think. Yeah, you wonder about the Roosters, don't you? Is it too late?
Well.
Give us up the...
Oh, not draw on the ladder. I think they're like 14th on the table or 13th.
And what's their points?
13th.
16? I know. 18. But they're only 4 points behind us. It's so deceptive. Very deceptive, the table this
but
year.
But it's only because you think they'll be going better. You would be a mad bet to get on them to win it now.
$81. I'm sorry, you wouldn't take my money.
But you'll take my 26s on the...
Yep, 26s on the Wires all day, man. There's still a chance, baby. Just a little bump in the road for the Wires. All right. That brings us into our next section, which is, Jason...
MVK'S.
It is. Most valuable Kiwis of the round. Do my dance, I'm the player of the day. Hey. Hey. Player of the day. Yeah. All right, player of the day, aka MVK'S, aka the most valuable Kiwis of the round. Jason, would you like to start?
Sure. I'll take the honors when I get on the right page. Okay. I'm going to change it up. I'm going to start off with my 1 point this week.
Okay, yeah.
Work up to it.
1, 2, 3.
1 point. Nikoda.
Brinton.
Brinton, Nikoda. Yes. Good game. As we said before, a couple of tries, a couple of lane breaks and all this. He was pretty good. This runs a great line.
He's a great line runner. He's a great defender as well.
He knows a thing or two about lines.
Yep. What are you saying there? I don't know what you're saying. Are you implying that he's...
No, I'm not.
What's that? Because I don't know.
No, I'm just saying he would make a great linesman.
Okay. A touchy, maybe. He can run that line. Sweet. Yeah, great defender as well.
Yeah.
No, he's a good player. Great player. All right, who was your two?
My two goes to Manu. As we just said before, was great.
Manu Vatavai?
Yep.
Sweet.
No, Joey Manu.
Joseph.
Like, he was just, even though they lost, he was quite important in that attack.
It was 150th game, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Two NRL
games. Shout out to 150.
Shout out to Joey Mann. The Kuroa's finest.
And my 3 points goes to, where is he on the board? Tarpenny. He was this.
Is he not on there?
Oh, there he is.
Wow.
He just hasn't really...
We haven't given him any points, Jase.
Tarpenny, he gets my three. He was great.
Nice.
Pretty sure he went close a couple of times.
Yeah. What was the stats again, bro?
One line break, six tackle breaks, 72 post-contact meters.
Shit.
One offload, and the kicker, the stinger, 43 tackles for zero missed, and 181 meters.
What a shift. And for that exact reason, Jason, I'm also giving Joseph Tarpenny my 3 points.
Oh, how good.
So give him six of the best. Should take him up a bit.
Yep, that'll put him up to... Oh.
Well, that'll refresh quick. That'll put him up to something.
It'll put him up to something.
Or not, if it didn't count them.
Should be on 8 points. Yeah, there he is.
There he is at 8.
13th.
13th, so he's fully jumped the queue there. My two also went to... Oh, no. Did you go Nikora for two?
No, I went him for Tahi.
I mean, Brinton Nikora as well. Epic game. Played very well. Great, like I said, great defender. Great line runner. Great skills for a back rower. So, for Nikora. And my last point, which was always hard to give out, I've gone with...
It is hard to give out.
Matt T. Moko.
The Mooks.
Up the Moko. Kia ora mai Moko. So, he's on 9 points, so he'll jump. Jump.
12th?
It should be 12th, yeah.
What did it change?
Huh? Did you put it on?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, I don't know. He's just taking a while to load.
Just taking a while to load up. All right.
Anyway, that hasn't really changed our top five.
No, so rattle off our top five, mate. Well, you can do our top 10 if you wanted to.
Okay. And first, the King, SJ. Second, do we do points or just go? Okay, the King in first, SJ on 49 points. Second, CNK on 44 points. Third, Dylan Brown on 20 points. Still sitting in third.
Still in third with having a... He's going to obviously sit out a few more games.
Yes. Four, Drew Marshall King, who could have got a point this week easily.
Could have. He was 19 points. He was on my list.
Fifth, Dallin Watini Zelezniak on 17 points. Sixth, Brinton Nikora on 18. Seventh, Jordan Ricky on 16. 8, Big Nasty 16 on
as 16. Well.
Tohu on 9 and 9th on 15 points. And then Joey Manu gets up to the top 10 on 14 points.
All right, so those are your MVKs, people.
Pretty sure Sam would have given him a
Joey Manu
3 points.
Here. But he's not here.
No.
So he can't. All right, so on to our next bit, which is preview
also,
of the round.
Just before we go into that.
Yes.
I seen a stat before about, is that this year? Must be.
Yeah.
Joey Taps, 95.3 tackle efficiency.
Shit, that's good, eh?
Yeah.
That's good. In the middle, too.
Mad dog. Anyway, preview of the round. Quick thing of who we're going to win is going to win.
Who's going to win and why?
Shorter round this week.
You got the little tiger pussycats.
Taking on the Sharks.
It's going to be a mauling.
Well, pardon me. Nico Hines and everything. Sharkies.
50 plus.
Man, they'd be feeling scared to come into this game after getting that put on them and then coming against the Sharks.
Yeah, 50 plus for me.
Yep. Raiders versus Dragons.
Oh, another. There's going to be another humping around.
Man, I reckon these two first games could go 50 plus.
Both games 50 plus. Yeah, I've got the Raiders. Joey Tarpenny to have another massive game.
Oh, all three games. Warriors over Eels. Warriors, 50 plus.
I'm going to go Warriors, though. I think the Eels got enough players out. that hopefully you don't play to be like...
That's why I would be happy if we put 50 plus on them. We need to.
Yeah. But I don't know if you, we can.
I'd be happy with 20 plus.
I'd be happy with 1 plus.
One plus. I'll be happy with a win.
We just need a win because it's getting very choked.
Yeah, we also need points differential.
Yeah, but because you can get that later.
Actually, no. We need to put 50 plus on them because Eels have got a weird points differential, even though it's been half the...
Plus 100 something.
Yeah, half the thing at the bottom of the table.
Yeah.
Rabbitohs Bulldogs.
Well, seeing the Rabbitohs play on the weekend.
Rabbitohs.
Rabbit and the Dogs play.
Cody Walker.
Yeah, I still think they got enough to...
And no Keelon...
Kalamatangi.
Yeah.
Keelon Kalamatangi, he can't play. But you can't take the Doggies after last week, sorry.
Up the Bulldogs.
You're not.
Up the Bulldogs.
You're not going to go to the Bulldogs.
Surely, they get up.
All right. Oh, another Queensland derby.
Titans versus Dolphins.
Well, this is probably the hard one to pick of the round. Shit, no JMK, I'm going to have to go Titans.
Yeah, I'm going to go Titans. They lose Brimson, but Jaden Campbell just slips in, surely.
Yeah, and then JMK is just such a big loss. The Dolphins just look...
Yeah.
It's like so much better with him playing, so...
I hear they're going to take Tafuti at the back.
Where? At fullback?
Fullback.
No.
Nah.
No way. I wouldn't mind seeing it, though.
That would be pretty good.
Bro get carried off the defense.
Sparta.
Yeah. Oh, ta-da.
Ta-da.
Shout out to the Prince of Ōtara, Valance Te Whare.
Yes.
Yeah, you have to go Titans on that.
Yeah.
A few buys. Sweet. All right. So, in saying that, Jason. Oh, I need to get this one right. I feel like it's this one. Yes. Yes. Bring up Kane. Another dollar to be made. Just another day. All right, that brings us to the best bet section. We both went 13 plus, didn't we? Why is 13 plus?
Well, hey, we can do that, but yeah.
No, but did you do that last week?
Oh, nah. I did a multi with... Well, I did it with Tamati, but he wasn't chosen, so I did DWZ, CNK, and AFB. None of them got a try, by the way.
Yeah, random. Yeah, that is a bit random, eh? All right, do you want to read it?
Sure. This is from that Kiwi punter. Sup, lads. Best bet this week incoming. Sivo to score a double. Sivo has a 100% strike rate against the Warriors. Hey! Scoring a try in all four games to date. Never mind, we won't do this bet. Now, I feel like when we do that, he does the bets against the Warriors do...
Did pretty well.
Yeah. Anyway, man is due to score, not crossing over his last two. That's right, because... Sorry, I'm digressing, but like a lot of people were waiting for him to try score because they put so many points on as well.
Yeah.
And he just didn't get across. With a good sweeping play, I think the overlap can be created out wide with Simonson setting us up. Hey?
With Simonson setting up the try, you know?
What do they do? Oh, and this is his next bet, is it?
Yeah. This is all leading to... Yeah. AJ got a double last weekend on the back of the AWZ's tendency to rush. What he's saying is that...
Yeah, sorry, I thought he was talking about...
He's trying to like point out some. There's a weakness in Bellin's defensive game, Kane.
No.
Okay,
it was just there was too many puddles out wide.
But yeah, maybe he does rush it. He likes the jam.
Sivo for a double.
He likes peanut butter and jam.
I like it. Ain't going to happen, but I like it.
I reckon Simonson for a double.
He's been playing good, man.
Bailey to get one at least.
Yeah.
All right, thanks, Kane. What do you got for this weekend, mate?
Obviously, I'm going to try to put a big margin on for the Warriors. But I'm going to go Jaden Campbell, two or more tries against the Dolphins.
Ooh.
He should slip into fullback, you would think.
Oh, hona yeha.
And, I just love the way he plays, and he's just unlucky that he just plays 14 the whole time.
Yeah, that's a hard one. He might need to shift somewhere else as well.
Yeah.
Not bad, bro. Actually, I like that. I've got Wales 13 plus and Bailey Simonson to get a Kumara.
Is this a multi-tuck?
You can multi-tuck if you want tuck.
You want to multi.
You can do a multi if you want, but I'll just be going Bailey to get the first try or a try.
Yep.
And Wires 113 plus. That's my best bet. If you're having your bet, that's the best.
Warriors 13 plus?
Yes.
310. We're favourites again.
What? I mean, I can see why, but it's like...
What?
Give us some value, man.
Yeah.
No, sweet as. Any other bets? You want to put the people on, or hey, you know, less is more.
Yeah,
sometimes.
Actually, I reckon because I've seen the Dragons, Tarpenny gets over for one this week.
Is he going to try this year yet?
I don't think so.
Don't think so. All right, Joseph Tarpenny, a bit of Kumara action up them. Hey, diddle diddle. Hey, diddle diddle middle. Sweet. That's it, isn't it? We got short round.
Quick Kiwi moment in the round.
Oh, yes, the favourite segment. Yes, what we got?
I've changed mine, so I'm going to go first, and then you can choose what you
want to
do.
Okay, yeah, surprise me.
My Kiwi moment is Big Nasty absolutely folding Isaiah Yo.
Yeah, that was a good hit. You like that, Isaiah Meow?
Oh, it was so good to watch.
Oh, Isaiah...
massive hit from Big Nasty. Like
Big Nasty, bloody rocked him.
Rocked him.
He get that up, yeah.
Yeah. This caption this here.
What's that? Get that up, yeah.
I don't know. Or just that nasty smoking yo, yo,
yo.
What about yours?
Mine. Oh, I had a couple, and then now I thought I had it, but now you changed yours.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to stick with my original one, which was the Team Uncle try for the Raiders.
It was a double whammy for Kiwis.
Double whammy because, pardon me, Jordan Rapana done all the hard mahi to set that up. He's a grafter. He's a grinder. He never gives up. He's always competing for everything, Jordan Rapana. And that's what set up that try for Team Uncle. What a play. What a try. They won a close game. There was nothing more to say about that, but except Team Walker was late to the team song. I don't know how what happened there.
That was funny, seeing boosting.
Yeah, so shout out to Team Walker and Jordan Rapana down there in Canberra. That would be my Kiwi moment of the round.
I like it.
Brilliant try. A brilliant try. Yeah, so that
a Sam brilliant try.
Sam brilliant try. But that would probably bring an end to our episode. Yes, we're supposed to get Bailey Simonson on, but unfortunately, Parramatta Eels media team have said, Narbol, not till after, not in season. So we will get Bailey on in the off season.
He's keen as get on.
Got a couple more players lined up, so hopefully, if their media teams let them do it, it'll be great. But maybe we'll just hold on to that as a bit of a surprise.
Yes.
Once again, good George. Shout out to the lads at, could be lad and ladettes. Could be some Sheilas there. Shout out to Good George.
Yes.
Back in the potty. Thanks for the beers. Don't forget, get to the website, buy anything online, Kiwi NRL 10, discount code for your bevvies. Get amongst it. Also, if you want our podcast for your kadus or fatus, depending on where you're from, where do they go?
Spotify. Oh, is that your eyes? Oh, yeah.
We'll get there one day. It's for your eyes. So it's YouTube. Then for your Tardingers.
It's your Spotify or your, what else are we on?
Apple Podcasts,
Podbean. Sorry, we'll just edit that other part out. That was very.
No, we'll leave it in. You'll get it. Just remember that Tardingers is ears, because that's the one you know.
That's why, as soon as I said it, I was like, why haven't you said Tardingers?
It's like, that's the one you know, bro.
Yeah.
That obviously means the other one is the eyes, okay? So next week, we'll test you again.
What is it, Katu or Fadus?
Kadu. Or Fatu.
I remember that.
And then Instagram at Kiwi NRL podcast. Same on Flacial Book. And don't forget, we're on the Techie Talk. We're hissing on there. And all our reels are easy. It's probably easier to watch on TikTok as well. All our stuff. Yeah. So jump on the Techie Talk as well. It's been great having you along tonight. I've been your host, Lenny Brookie.
And I've been the lefty,
Jason Weatherly. And for that,
do you know what I've realised? I'm on your left, but on the camera, I'm on the right.
Oh, that's why I see my left. My left hand man.
Yes.
My Lucy Lefty.
Yes.
All right. Anyway, I bid you farewell. I bid you adieu.
Goodbye.
See you later.
And up the waz.
Up the waz. You know what it takes, and you're ready today to take them all on. You got the measure of your man, and you know that you can go all the way. Give it to him. Yeah, give him a taste. Give him.